Let's deal with the lines going out of borders of our workspace. It happens because when we calculate the coordinates, we include the height and width of the entire window, not just the canvas. Again, holding the Alt key, replace this with your canvas. This way, lines will not go beyond the scene size of the canvas. Add customization to the thickness of lines. Right now it is fixed. Create a new combo box to choose different thickness. This combo box will not be such a headache as the two previous ones, since we will fill it with specific combo box items. Add a descriptive text block first. Give the combo box a name. For each item in the combo box, you need to use a combo box item. In its content property, type the stroke thickness that you would like to allow. You can choose which item will be selected on start by setting the IsSelected property to true. Before we proceed, look why I have chosen the toolbar. When controls don't have enough space, they automatically hide by default. You can also force controls to be hidden under the arrow button by setting the toolbar overflow mode to always. And now let's get back to the thickness. It is always 2 because we do not get it from the combo box. Just 2 quick adjustments. First, in your constructor, set the color brush combo box selected index to 7. So that it is black on the start. Second, in your constructor, set the background color combo box selected index to go 8 items back from the end, so that it is transparent on the start instead of white. So let's get to the thickness from the combo box. Just convert to int 32 the text of combo thickness. And don't forget to remove the old setting. And there you have it. Lines with custom thickness. Talking about its applications. When you generate multiple lines at once, you can get some nice logos. You may ask, those are just lines, are you sure? Yes. Before recording this video, I have managed to randomly get the icons of Visual Studio and Telegram. Not sure if minimalism or just lazy? Well, make your own conclusions about the work of modern logo designers. Let's add dynamic random thickness. We will need a new combo box. Copy your grid with the combo box and paste. Change its name. In C#, copy the line where you checked the randomness of color and paste it right before setting the stroke thickness. Change combo color to combo thickness. Let's check how it works. The thickness is changed, but the program ignores the checkbox. I accidentally have not replaced the checkbox. Change checkbox to checkbox random thickness. Let's check again. Now, the thickness is not changed if the random checkbox is not checked. If the checkbox is checked, it changes the thickness dynamically. Let's check how it works with multiple lines. Yes, it works. Thanks for watching.